Come to the fifth problem. Now I am reading the problem. Enter the following transactions in proper subsidiary books. Once again I am repeating. Enter the following transactions in proper subsidiary books. Here the examiner is not clearly mentioned to prepare proper subsidiary books. Means he is asking to prepare proper subsidiary book based on number of transactions. Based on these three or four transactions, we have to identify which type of subsidiary books we are going to prepare. That is most important while you are going to read the problem. Again, I'm reading the problem. Enter the following transactions in proper subsidiary books. So the examiner is not mentioned to prepare particular subsidiary books. So that's the reason we have to identify eight types of subsidiary books are not there. So or there in or not there. So that's the reason. And come to the first one, way first. Goods returned to Sai. So goods returned to Sai. To Sai is nothing but PRB, purchase return book. Yes ma'am. Goods returned to Sai means Sai return goods. Then it will goes to purchase return book. One thing we are identified. Next one, goods return to Ram. To Ram is nothing but it is also purchase return book. It also goes to purchase return book. And come to next one, goods returned from Sri. From Sri is nothing but sales return book. Next one, goods returned by Veda. By Veda is also goes to a sales return book. How I can identify these four transactions are relating to particular proper subsidiary book? That's the reason once again I am repeating. Goods returned to Sai. Here there is no purchase and there is no sale. So if the transaction is having returned to a name of the person, definitely it will be called as a purchase return book. So that's the reason I am identified. The transaction will be goes to in our purchase return book. And come to the next one, goods returned to Ram. This is also returned to a name of the person. It will also goes to in our purchase return book. So both are similar books. Means this is first one and this is also your first one. And come to the next one. Means we have identified one book, purchase return book. This is also purchase return book. And come to the next one, goods returned from Sri. If the transaction is having a name of returned from Sri, from Sri is all called as goods sales returned book. And next one, returned by, from or by, both are same. If the returned by is also there, then it will also called as sales return book. This is a second book of subsidiary books. So two books we are identified. First one is purchase return book and second one is sales return book. So according to this we have to prepare pro forma. And come to the pro forma solution number 5. This one is purchase return book. First column similar date, particulars, the book number, check for your number, total amount, and total amount. And next one, sales. Then come to solve this one. First one, 2019 May 1st, that will be in our purchase return book. Write the year, month and day which are considered. Goods returned to Sai. Goods returned to Sai. Value is 1000 and second transaction date is important. This is also in our purchase return book. Second day return two goods. Return to Ram worth of second transaction 2000. And come to the next one. Goods returned from Sri Satwin will go to sales return book. That will be our second book. And in every new book, we have to enter year, month, and day of the transaction. That is goods returned from Sri. Worth 500. And next two transaction date is 4. Goods returned by Veda worth is also 500. So all transactions are completed. Before totalizing the problem, once again we have to see all transactions are perfectly, we are converted into proper books of accounts or not. First one, goods returned to Sai is nothing but it is called as purchase return book. Goods returned to Ram, return to Ram is also a part of purchase return book. Next one, goods returned from Sri 500, from Sri is nothing but sales return book. Next one, goods returned by Veda, by or from, both are similar, it will also come under into our sales return book. So identify the day wise transaction. First and second dates are comes under into purchase return book. First and second date transactions are completed. And next one, third and fourth transactions are comes under into sales return book. Dates we are identified. Then finally totalize the problem. 3000 year total of purchase returns and here total of sales returns. This is our problem. Then we have to identify clearly.